Hi everyone, today I'm going to do a simulation on Ansys. I'm going to try to do a tutorial out of a solar absorber plate. This is the problem statement. Basically, it's a solar absorber plate. It looks like this. Basically, it's a plate with copper tubing going down the center. These are stacked up, so I'm only going to be simulating one of these. And the copper plate has a length of 2 meters, height of 40 centimeters, a thickness of 8 millimeters. And the copper tube going through the center has an outer diameter of 22 millimeters and an inner diameter of 21.4 millimeters. The fluid we're going to be simulating is water. Liquid water going through the tube. For the boundary conditions, the top surface is going to have a heat flux of 800 watts per meter squared. All of the other surfaces are going to be free convection with a H of 15, and the T infinity, or the free stream temperature, is going to be 293 Kelvin. Fluid inlet, it's going to be a velocity inlet. I am going to start with 0.1 meters per second. I'm not quite sure if I'm going to stick with that. Depends on what temperature contours we get. I want to show that the heat is being transferred to the water. We might have to slow that down or maybe speed it up. I'm not sure yet. And then the fluid outlet is going to be a pressure outlet. And the interface is going to be a coupled wall. So I'm pretty new to all of these programs, but the reason why I'm doing this simulation is because I couldn't find anyone else who showed in detail how to do a solid to fluid, heat transfer problem in using Ansys and Fluent. So I'm going to go ahead and start by making the geometry in Solidworks, and then I'm going to import it over to Ansys. It's going to take some time, and I want to say ahead of time that I'm sure there are a ton of different, more efficient ways of doing what I'm going to do, but what I am going to show you works, and to me that's all that matters right now. So I'm going to go ahead and start making the geometry for this. So let me make sure that my units are correct. Okay, using meters, that's good. I'm gonna go ahead and start the sketch on the front plane. And height, we said we wanted it to be 0.40, so 40 centimeters. The thickness I want to make 0.008, so 8 millimeters. Okay, cool. Now, what I want to do is find the center wherever that is, and I want to, I'm going to put a construction line there, and reason being is because I'm going to put a circle representing the copper pipe in the center. And let me go ahead and put a dimension on that. Okay, so we're gonna do 0.022, which is 22 millimeters as the outer diameter. Just make sure that's right. Yeah, 22 millimeters for the outer diameter. Okay, and let's go ahead and trim out everything we don't need. We don't need that either. Okay, so now we should be ready to extrude this, hopefully. We'll go ahead and do this, take the sketch as selected, extrude it, and the length in this direction is what I'm doing right now. It's going to be 2 meters. Okay, so it looks like that worked for us. Alright, now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to enter sketch on the front plane. I'm going to extrude out the center to go ahead and make the inner diameter of the plate. So let me go ahead and try to do that. Okay, and this diameter is going to be 0.0214 meters, which is going to be, that's the inner diameter, so that's good. And now, I'm going to go ahead and extrude that, extrude cut through all. Like so. And that looks pretty good. Let's make sure that's right. Oops. Hopefully we won't have any problems with this, but I think it's going to be okay. Let's go ahead and save it as a part. Let's do absorber plate. Okay. Now I'm gonna do separately. I know there's different ways of doing this, but I'm gonna separately create the inner fluid domain. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. Front plane. And yes, and extrude, and we're gonna go 2 meters. Yes. Okay, so that should be good for our fluid domain. And let me go ahead and save that as fluid. Okay. Now I'm going to create an assembly. Join them together. Could probably do this much easier with what's this called? Some other program or some other way of doing it, but this is just what's worked for me. I'm going to mate these two parts. Concentric, and let's go ahead and do that's good. I'm gonna make these two things coincidence if I can. Bam. Okay. Should be good now. check that.